doing, man? Nice to be back. Hope this capturing the whole shot. All right. Thank you for coming back, guys, frequent visitors and new visitors, everybody, man. Thank you for coming back and checking out this humble channel here. Happy holidays to everybody. You know, before I forget, you know, hope you guys have a safe holiday season. And, you know, very happy new year. In case I don't see you till next time, we'll probably be over in 17. So, happy holidays, man. Man, this is draining, man, you know? It's a lot of action, you know. Anyway, but it's worth it, man, because I love this song, you know. The old Black Sabbath, man. You know, it's, wow. What can we say? You know, I wanted to do another one because I love this stuff, you know. And I did Children of the Sea last month. And I don't know, you know, it came out rather decent, you know. And so I figured let's make something even harder, you know. As always challenging myself to push even harder, you know, which could be dangerous because you could bite more than you can chew and make a fool out of yourself. But hopefully, you know, it came out half decent, so hope you guys found some entertainment value from it. What can I say? I don't have much to say, really. Except we could just let's go over this the song and tell you some personal anecdotes, personal opinions about. I personally grew up with the Black Sabbath, you know, and I love all eras of Black Sabbath, you know. Especially the Dio era, you know, because I was coming up on my teenage years and you know, when Dio broke out and all that stuff, and it was just beautiful, man, you know. So, I mean, I like the Ozzy stuff too, but the Dio Sabbath was more just, I don't know, more modern and more melodic and everything, and melodic, I don't know, but I don't know, just more modern-esque, you know. It was a step above the Ozzy stuff, so I love the stuff. I mean, I ate it all up, man. You know, I was just, you know, so I saw Steel Sabbath a bunch of times. I just been listening to that music forever, you know. And this is a great thing to do, you know, to finally be able to interpret the Dio song in my own way, you know, with respecting the original. But throw my little things in there, you know, and I want to go over it, you know, a little bit, because there's some interesting stuff in this song, and what else? I don't want to miss anything. I wanted to say some things here. Yeah. So let's go over it, man. You know what I found, you know, interesting. I mean, I've known Tony Iommi for a long time. He's possibly my favorite guitar player. Next to Eddie Van Halen, I mean, it's really up for grabs, you know, both of them. I don't know who, you know, and they're so different, right? Black Sabbath is dark and you know, mysterious, and Van Halen is so beachy and summer-like, you know, and but the, I don't know. But, you know, Iommi always had those, you know, he was always making riffs out, the riffs that are so meaningful, and they just beckon good songwriting around it, you know, and just hit the spot, you know, as well as Eddie Van Halen. So see, I don't know, they're both really my top two guitar players. Then yeah, so anyway, what can I say to you guys? Well, we're using this one here, and one of the first things that I've kind of noticed about, you know, researching the song here before I, you know, I do these songs, I research them a bit, you know, I don't want to make mistakes trying to do my own thing too much, you know. So in my research, I noticed that a lot of people, they play the riff, and they go, and they play the, you know, I don't even know how to play it here. But anyway, they play this part. I don't even know. You see, I'm not going to figure it out right now, but they play it mostly up there. Some people. And I don't know if that's the correct way, but ever since I was a young dude, I always played it this way. Maybe it's harder, but what I like about it is that it's right there with the E. So I don't know who, how I gotta look at Iommi's playing, see how he does it. But some people doing it this way. So I was like, yeah, I never played it that way, so. So anyway, I found it pretty nice. It's got some different voicing here, you know. The same thing, you know, just up here. But the E chord is right here, so I don't have to go back to, you know, just the mini second that it takes to go back into the E. I don't know, it might take up some time in the playing, so it's good that it's immediate, right here, you know? Okay, so that's one thing that always stuck, you know, and I always you know, admired Tony Iommi for his playing, you know, it's a very flurry, that's a lot of you know, right? That's a lot of that stuff. But this solo is like, this solo is a very weird solo. The beginning is a beautiful thing because it's a melodic, I think it's a melodic improvisational, you know, Iommi always improvises on stuff on his solos, but this is a beautiful improvisation. It just fits so well, you know, and if you play this song, you really have to respect that and play the beginning of, at least the beginning of the solo. You know, I would say respect the whole solo. Now, the outro is up for grabs if you want to do something, you know, more personal. But in the beginning, I think to respect that. But anyway, we've been using the warm pickup lately, you know. I've been getting into the warm pickup train lately. So I figured throw the warm pickup on there like I did coming from Children of the Sea last time. I threw the warm pickup onto the line. And it's kind of nice, you know, it's a different texture. All these warm pickups sound pretty cool, you know. So anyway, excuse me, let me see if this is recording because I'm not wasting my time over here, you know what I mean? All right. I'm going Brooklyn on you. Anyway, I'll try to make this short. So, you know, I don't want you to sit here for 15 minutes watching this stuff. But, yeah, man. So we'll throw the warm pickup for the solo here, just for textures, you know, and he begins with what? He begins with, it's a very intricate part. That's pretty much the one phrase. I hope I'm not too low. Right? So again, beautiful. So some some blues licks, things in the solo. I noticed it. So that's a blues thing there. I've seen it before. I'm saying. So he's using this the extension of the E minor scale here. see? It's an extension kind of thing. Something like that, right? Is that a pickup thing? I decided to do my own thing a little bit. More or less, very much like the solo, hopefully, right? My interpretation of it. But because you need the backing with it, and so I'm gonna put the backing on. But you know, I mean, let's start over again. Yeah. That's what something like I did in the song here. Anyway, so that's that. That's the solo, right? In my kind of way of doing it, but very much respecting most of this original motifs here. Beautiful, beautiful thing. It just fits so perfect, you know. And the warm pickup is nice. So. That's that, man, you know, and what else? What can I tell you about this song? This song, you know, the backing behind the solo is beautiful too, you know. That's the backing solo, that's what sets it up, you know. It's got a nice backing, melodic foundation for the solo part. So that's why it's a beautiful thing. It's a minor, E minor. In this case, it's a E flat minor feel to it, you know. But you learn a lot, you know. And I've been playing this for a long time. And I'll show you, man, what I got here. Right? I bought this a long time ago, man. The Black Sabbath Anthology. Huh? Long time ago I bought this. Let me see if this is recording. Alright. Yeah. I bought this a while back. I don't know if you can still find this online somewhere. But it's a good book, man, because it has all the Aussie stuff and the Dio era stuff, you know, the Untappd. You know, the tab and the music and the chords and all that, and it's been very helpful throughout the years. And it's got the solos, and the solos are pretty much note for note, you know what I mean? The Black Sabbath Anthology, you know. So if you can find this, I recommend this book for you guys who want to pick up the Dio era stuff and the Aussie stuff. It's got good tab, you know, accurate. And because I went over the solo for this, and pretty accurate, you know. It's just, you know, because you got the more accurate, the better. Anyway, So, what else? So, anyway, so, yeah, so pretty much, it's, you know, it's just not a, it's not rocket science. This is just good, it's a good song, and Dio singing is incredible, you know. Ronnie James Dio, man, you know, wow. But, you know, I love that. We love Ronnie James Dio, man, because he put so much mystery into the music and just the elegant darkness into it, you know. It's not cheesy, it's not, it was never cheesy, it was very elegant. And even to his horns, right? I remember, man, Ronnie James Dio wouldn't just go like this, you know, hey, what's up, you know, metal, you know, no, you would do this, like a thing like that, right? I kind of picked that up too, believe it or not, man. I was like, you know, did it to my postman the other day. You know, if all he brings me is bills, man. So, hey, what are you doing? You're fucking bills here all the time, man. He said, don't do that. Don't do that. Sorry, I'm sorry, man. As soon as he turned his back over. But anyway, that's what you got to do, it like this. You know? Like a swing to it. If you could do this, even better. Hey, so, yeah, man. Good stuff, you know. Put that. Try it. Go to the store and go like, you get arrested by that. Anyway, with that said, what happens, right? Oh my God, this guitar, and I'm, you know, at the end of the song. Sometimes we're in the momentum of the song. You know? We keep playing. In the momentum of when the song ends, we're so adrenalized and into it that it inspires, for me, it inspires more riffs. Neon lights. You just keep playing. It inspires you. You get into that, you know. There's a way of creating riffs. Is you got to know your own momentum, your own soul. You know, if you're like all riled up. Thank you. You come up with riffs like that, you know, because you're using your momentum, your excitement that you have at the moment. That's a nice idea, a way of creating music, you know. Anyway, so. That one, I got into that, right? So I pulled that, for some reason I pulled this out, right? And I went. So I said, hey man, what if I do a little heavy version of Sunshine of Your Love with the detune I've been talking about, you know, for such a long time, right? The detune of this, detune of that, right? And I said, yeah, might do like an Alice in Chains kind of thing. And since we're coming from this Dio singing, which is, you know, very, you know, up there, I said, let me do a contrary motion here. And, and we'll do more of a normal, lower voice, softer thing. So, hence this version of Sunshine You'll Love with the drop C sharp, actually, because we're in E minor, we're in E flat. So if you drop the D, we're talking C sharp, you know, so. Forgot the riff now. Something like that. Anyway. Little palm mute. Gives it even heavier. Mm-hmm. seventh, right? Then for the solo, right? Again, the one pickup. Here. It ain't about speed anymore. It's about vibrato. How you could bend a note into a nice melodic thing. See, right here I'm using three notes. Middle one. Second half of the solo. You know, some different things in this this song here, man. Okay, you know, pretty much it, man. I don't want to take too much of your time, and we'll make more videos soon, all right? So, but listen, man, you know, sunshine of your love, man. If you know, if you got a guitar and you don't know how to play that riff, I don't know, maybe you should just auction that thing off or something, man, because I don't know, you don't deserve a guitar, man, if you can't play that riff, right? If you can't play Paranoid riff, Smoke on the Water riff, Sunshine of Your Love riff, and You Really Got Me, give that guitar to somebody else, man, alright? I'm sure you can, though, so
yeah, man.
Keep practicing, man, you know, and thank you very much for coming by. You know, thank you very much. Battery died in me. But I was prepared this time. I got a shitload of batteries over there, and they're all charged, man. So, you know. Thank you again. You know, this is the battery died on my goodbye segment. Thank you for coming by, man. Appreciate it very much. You guys are pretty cool. I really value you guys' time and your comments, if you got any questions, any observations. Just be kind all around, man, you know. Everybody's doing whatever they can, you know, in the more humble way with what they got. So, you know, respect is a good thing to have in the social media world, you know. I mean, I fool around a lot, you know what I mean, online and everything, but there's never an insult, or I don't insult anyone or any, you know. But thank you, man. Thank you for coming. You know, I really appreciate your time. And again, happy holidays. You guys be safe. All right? Take care. I'll see you next time in rock. Cheers.